I'm going to show you how to blur out moving objects. I probably haven't looked this good in a minute. What's good, my blurry-faced PD peeps? Thank you so much for choosing this tutorial to learn how to blur out some stuff using PowerDirector Mobile. Blurring allows you to cover up people or things that you don't want shown in your videos. It's a great way to remove unwanted content without negatively impacting the quality of your video. I'm about to rub some fools out. As you can see here, I have a video of a girl dancing on the main timeline track, and I want to blur out her pretty little face. So, I want to go ahead and tap on the overlay icon. And then I'm going to go down here to effect layer. And you can choose from mosaic, blur, or highlight. I'm going to choose mosaic. And then I'm going to tap on the plus sign to add it to an overlay track on the timeline. Now I'm going to go ahead and tap on the mosaic on the timeline, the little green clip here. Then I'm going to go ahead and place my finger over the edge and hold it down and drag this out so that it matches the duration of the clip above it. And I'm going to go ahead and move my playhead back to the beginning. Now, at this point, if I wanted to, I could change the type. Down here at the bottom, I could click on type. And then I still have mosaic, blur, and highlight. But I'm going to stick with mosaic, so I'm going to tap back. And then next, you could pick your shape. So if you type on shape, you could choose between ellipse, rectangle, or a curved edge rectangle. So I'm going to go ahead and stick with ellipse. Tap on that. And now what I want to do is change the width and the height. I'm going to go ahead and place my finger over this little icon that has the arrows pointed diagonally. And I'm just going to drag it in. I could change the height. I could change the width, all of that good stuff. And then once I have it how I want it, I could just place my finger over the middle and drag it over the face. And then I'm done. I can go ahead and tap on back. And basically, I have the blur, but I need this blur to follow her as she moves because she's dancing, twisting, turning, getting the fellas yearning. And I need to go ahead and make sure that the blur stays on her face. So to do that, I'm going to tap on transform keyframe. And then I'm going to tap on the keyframe icon to add a keyframe at the beginning. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag my finger across the timeline and move the playhead forward to a position where I feel there's enough movement. Once I feel there's enough movement, I want to go ahead and place my finger over the blur and then drag it. This will make a new keyframe wherever I drag it, and it'll make the blur move when the video gets to play. So you just keep doing this, keep moving your playhead and positioning the blur where you need to put it. And once you're done creating all of your keyframes, you just can tap on the timeline, move your playhead back to the beginning, and you can press play. Look at that sexy blur. Our channel is dedicated to teaching you how to use PowerDirector Mobile. So if you want more PowerDirector Mobile tutorial love, smash the subscribe button. If you don't own the app and you like what you see, I'll leave my affiliate link to try PowerDirector in the video description. Using it helps support the channel so I can make more content for you. Shout out to Team PDU for their support and for clicking the join button underneath this video. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.